And now without further ado, the Honolulu Japanese Chamber of Commerce is honored to present this year's prestigious Generational Award to a member family which exemplifies the following characteristics. A locally owned or locally established company whose family's ownership and or management spans at least two generations, who has a reputation of sound corporate citizenship, and who is an active supporter of our community. For their support of the Honolulu Japanese Chamber of Commerce, we are proud to recognize Aloha Tofu Factory and the Uyehara family as this year's Generational Award recipient. Before we introduce Paul Uyehara, I would like to call back to the stage Governor David Ige, who will present a special commendation, and Candace Naito, who will also present an award plaque to the Uyehara family.
Thank you, Paul. If you could just come up, I just wanted to just briefly congratulate Paul Uyehara and Aloha Tofu Factory on their great family tradition of keeping tofu top of mind here in the state of Hawaii. So it's really an honor and privilege for me to, as governor, along with Lieutenant Governor Shan Tsutsui, to proclaim July 4th, 2015, Aloha Tofu Factory Day. In honor of this award. Congratulations.
Very quickly, I'll say a few words. First off, the Honorable Governor David Ige and First Lady Don Ige, honored guests, Honolulu Japanese Chamber of Commerce officers and directors, members of the Honolulu Japanese Chamber of Commerce, fellow businessmen, co-workers, family, and friends. Aloha! Tofu. On behalf of the UR family and our ohana at Aloha Tofu, I would like to express my deepest appreciation to the Honolulu Japanese Chamber of Commerce for their recognition of Aloha Tofu Factory as the 2015 Generational Award recipient. This is Aloha Tofu's 65th year, a year when most people would think about retirement and enjoying a well-deserved break from their years of hard work. For businesses, however, this concept does not apply. As we all know, in order to keep thriving or even surviving in Hawaii, there is very little time to sit back and reflect on how far you've come. Most of the time, you're just pushing forward, doing what needs to be done. I'm reminded of a quote, "Do or do not, there is no try." That is by one of the great teachers of our generation, Yoda. But it reminds me of the effort my grandparents and the second generation had to put forth in order to succeed. They had to move forward, and I am humbled and grateful to them. In fact, as a way to honor my grandfather, I am wearing one of his silk dress shirts today. As you can tell, he was a pretty snazzy dresser. He always went to Chinatown. We didn't know where he went, but he was always on the bus every morning, went to Chinatown and came back in the evening. I think he would be very excited and thankful for this honor if he were here with us today. Just as no man is an island, no company can succeed without the cooperation of many. My wife, Misa, kept reminding me who I needed to thank. So as I was pretending to listen to her, these came to mind. We are thankful for the tremendous community support we have received throughout the years, especially from organizations such as the Honolulu Japanese Chamber of Commerce, the Hawaii United Okinawan Association, and the Hawaii Food Manufacturers Association. Thank you for putting me through college. I wish to sincerely thank Seiwajuku Hawaii, the business group that I belong to, that has given me guidance and support in focusing on the importance of our employees and their happiness. This group has helped me to develop goals and a direction for the company to move forward. In a sense, their support has given me courage to try new things. I also want to say thank you to Joanne Hiramia and GM Productions for the beautiful video. We'll be sure to use it extensively. A special thanks to Mark Ibarra and the staff at Edward Enterprises. Those little green boxes in front of you, they are filled with a special custom-made cookie made with okada, created by our pastry chef, Misaki-san. I want to say mahalo to the employees of Aloha Tofu and Aloha Tofu Town. Tables 45 and 46, yeah? 45, 46, Aloha Tofu. Can you give them a hand? We're so grateful and thought this was such an important event that we closed the factory today and tomorrow. And so I'm guessing there are some older Japanese ladies banging on the gate outside saying, "What's going on? Where's my tofu?" But they'll have to wait a couple days. Working in a factory is a grind. It's a real grind. But the employees are there every day, sometimes at night, making the products that you all enjoy. I am grateful to the second generation for creating the solid foundation on which the company now stands. I may not have been blessed with their business acumen, but at least I have the curse of being able to work hard. On a more personal note, I would like to thank my wife, Misa, for her patience, understanding, and cooperation through these past and probably future years. Sometimes I do this too. And lastly, to all of you, I want to express my deepest, heartfelt, domo, arigatoufu.
But yes, congratulations again to Aloha Tofu Factory and the Uyehara family, this year's generational award recipient. Omarami.